What is up guys, Andy, Forest Team Runner here, and I'm back with a video for you today talking about my top tips for you if you are looking to run your first marathon. Now, there are lots of videos out there about this, there are lots of blogs out there about this, and you will get a lot of advice about it, but I want to share with you some alternative tips, some alternative ones, because I think there is some amazing advice out there and some great advice, and you can get lots of reliable stuff. However, I feel there's lots of stuff you don't get told when you're running your first marathon. And I want to share with you how I feel I could have benefited if I'd have known these tips. Now, if you do know, my first marathon was a disaster. It was Gloucester City Marathon. It will be 2 years ago this summer. And unfortunately, I crashed out at mile 17. It was a horrific experience and I vowed I would never run a marathon again. Well, we're going to change that this year, guys. And I also ran my own marathon last year. So I've learned a lot since then and I want to share with you my tips to how to run a better and more successful first marathon. Okay guys, tip number one, run a 15 to 20 mile race. I say that because most people progress through running by going 5K, 10K, half marathon, marathon. And the 5K to half marathon band is kind of a reasonable distance to progress to. There are very clear and achievable milestones, but going from half marathon jumping up to a marathon is quite a big distance. Something I wish I'd train myself in, because do you know what? That jump, if you race a half marathon and you actually race it, you don't just go and jog it easy and treat it as a long run, an easy run. If you race it hard or you race it reasonably, you cross that line and you think, oh my word, if I ever had to run a marathon, I'd have to do that all over again. And suddenly the mental prospect is massive. I think what people forget is the jump between the half marathon and marathon is so big, and there typically is no way to break it up. And there's not particularly either a standard distance between 13.1 and 26.2 miles. However, there are 15 to 20 mile races around. You need to mentally get ready to race further than a half marathon. You need to get in your head that there is a distance past a half marathon. This is something that I didn't do and couldn't get, and I really focused on the marathon being two half marathons, and mentally it was extremely challenging. So my recommendation there is, if you can, book a race that's in between 50 to 20 miles. As I said, there's not a standard and distance there, and they're not particularly the most common races. However, they are dotted around, and they tend to fall, if you've got an April marathon, they tend to fall around end of February to middle of March. And they're kind of warm-ups. We have a couple around here, but as I said, they're not common, but if you can find one, do it. Honestly, it will help you mentally prepare for the marathon. It will teach you to understand that you're going to be racing further than a half marathon, and it will just take you that little step closer. It will bridge the gap between half marathon to marathon and allow you to understand that you need to treat the marathon distance with a heck of a lot more respect than a half marathon. So that is my tip number one. Find a race between 15 to 20 miles and race it. Okay guys, tip number two, mentally break up the marathon into smaller chunks. Again, if you're used to running half marathons and you're taking that leap to a marathon, do not think to yourself that it is two half marathons. I mean, logically, it is two half marathons, but honestly, when you cross that halfway mark, you'll go, oh my gosh, I've got to do this again. And it's quite mentally mentally torturous. You might be a really mentally tough person, and then this point won't apply to you, so you can switch off. But for 9 out of 10 people, including myself, it absolutely broke me in my first marathon. So what I did in my second marathon was I broke things down into 5 mile chunks. So I took things every 5 miles. I evaluated, I went, tapped into my mind and went, right, how am I feeling? How's my form? How's my nutrition? Do I need anything? And I just broke it down that way. It makes life so much easier. At 5 miles, at 10, at 15, at 20, and then the last one I just chucked into a 10K. Because at the end of the day, a marathon does really start in the last 10K. It does start at 20 miles. But by breaking it down smaller, it didn't feel such a daunting task. It really didn't. You've got to mentally play the game of the marathon. The marathon isn't just physical, but it's just as mental, if not more. And if you're not tuned into that, it will break you. So definitely think about and start to work on your long runs, breaking it down into shorter and smaller chunks. 100%, guys, that is the best advice I could give you. So that's tip number two, break it down smaller. Number three, guys, the final point. This is a bit more generic and you might have heard this, but train with your equipment and nutrition that you are going to be taking. So study the course, learn out where the stations are, where you can pick up fluid, where you can pick up gels. Most marathons detail this, and if they don't, drop them an email. You need to, in your head, be practicing on your long runs. If you know there's going to be a water station every 5k or 5 miles, you need to practice drinking every 5k or 5 miles. Now, yes, you will probably no doubt take a water bottle with you, and you'll have your gels in a pouch somewhere, but if you run out and you need a backup plan, you need to know where these things are on the course. So study the course, work out where they're going to be, incorporate that into your training. I can also throw into the whole elevation, studying the profile and that sort of thing. And yes, that's fantastic, you could. But for your first marathon, I would just solely focus on working out where those stations are, where you're going to be able to pick up water, where you're going to maybe be able to refill your water bottles, and just simply work on taking on nutrition at the same time as when you will be in the marathon. I can't stress that highly enough. Again, at the marathon that we did, totally did not do that, just had a small water bottle with me. It was a super hot day and we got so dehydrated, I was cramping and everything at mile 21-22. Again, as I said, this is advice is purely coming from me and my experiences. I want to share this with you. I want you to be more prepared than I am. So study that course, work out where those stations are, and be prepared in training to be taking on fluid and nutrition where, in theory, in the race you'll be able to too. So that is my third and final tip. Hey guys, so that is it. Those are my top three tips for you if you are looking to run your first marathon. As I said, guys, these are coming from purely experience. I wanted to share them with you and I want to see you guys not fall into the same pitfalls that I did on my first marathon. So yeah, that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. As always, you know what to do. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Do subscribe to the channel for weekly running content and give it a share if you would be good enough. I will see you later in the week for week 10 update of the training series. As this video is being recorded tonight, we have got our 12 by 1k reps, the beast of the session, the biggest session in the whole plan. Wish us luck, and I will see you later in the week with a video for that one. Until then.